Hi everyone, good Thursday afternoon and welcome to Go Local Live. I'm Go Local News editor Kate Nagel. Thanks for tuning in with us downtown. I would like to welcome my first guest, Kim Barker-Lee, IGT's first ever Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion. Kim, thank you for joining us in studio today.
Thank you for having me.
Well, we're only a few blocks from IGT's gleaming headquarters here in Providence, but Kim came a little further away, lured you in from the Windy City of Chicago here to Providence. So last week we had some homegrown talent. I want to talk with you a little bit about the position, but coming to Rhode Island, you traded in the Windy City for the Ocean State. Tell us about your journey and how you found Rhode Island so far.
Sure. The great thing is I actually worked for IGT in Chicago for many years, so I knew the company and I knew the great people that were here. And so from that perspective, it was really a no-brainer to come here to Rhode Island and to work in Providence. But, you know, any move is difficult. I have a family, and so always concerned about changing your routine, changing everything when you go to a new state. And what I have found is between my colleagues, my neighbors, and people that I just meet, everyone has been such great ambassadors for Rhode Island, making my transition really seamless and easy, even when you're trying to rebuild everything. And so I have just been welcomed with open arms across the board, and it has been a great transition for me and my family.
We were just chatting in the green room, and Kim has gotten really a taste of Rhode Island because now she knows how to give and get directions from where things used to be. So I think that makes you kind of, if not a native Rhode Islander, an honorary Rhode Islander. And now that you're here, I want to talk a little bit about the position. Now, the fact that it's the first ever Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion. Tell us a little bit about your path at IGT. The decision to take on this role, and then what the role entails.
Yeah, I mean, I think diversity and inclusion is something that IGT has always been aware of, and we certainly have a long-standing commitment to promoting women in leadership, and we did some work around that in 2015, and the thought was from our leadership to really create a dedicated position to provide thought leadership, consulting, and accountability across our global company mm-hmm. for diversity and inclusion. And by diversity, we're talking about the mix of our people. And inclusion means how we leverage that diversity, how we leverage those differences to promote the company and to really deliver more for our customers in terms of products and innovation. I come to the position from a different perspective. I actually practiced law for 25 years, eight of which I spent practicing law with IGT. Diversity and inclusion and supplier diversity had always been a part of my commitment to the company. When we were looking for this new leader, as I read the job description, thought about both my passions and my background and experience and thought I could really do some incredible work for IGT in this area. And I have not looked back on transitioning out of a legal career once since I've taken the position.
And coming here to Rhode Island, you know, one of the things that IGT talks about is the 1,100 jobs that are here, of which we learned last week 65 are necessary for the operations here in Rhode Island, but the rest obviously is by lieu of here in Rhode Island being committed to having that footprint here. But, you know, those jobs, let's just talk about that composition of, you know, here in Rhode Island, and we'll go to your traveling worldwide. Folks might think IGT, maybe I need to be a techie, maybe I need to be that sort of a corporate top level, but there's so many positions throughout the company that really need a wide range of talents, of folks to contribute. So talk with us a little bit about that sort of holistic look. It's not all C-suite, and it's not all science-minded tech individuals. It's a whole host of folks who make the company run.
Yeah, absolutely. It takes different people, it takes different minds, it takes different expertise and professional experiences to really deliver for a global customer base. Here in Rhode Island, I think we're fortunate because we see that reflected in our workplace. We have, in our Rhode Island headquarters, we have our people in transformation, human resources, which is the area that I sit in. We have finance, legal, in addition to our lottery operations and technology. And so it takes a kind of wide array of skills to really deliver for customers. And I think that's one of the things that our IGTers love is the diversity of colleagues that we have, both from a kind of demographic perspective, but then also looking at professional experiences. And it allows us to really collaborate and bring different voices and different perspectives to how we deliver for our customers. I would say for people looking for opportunities within IGT here in Rhode Island, there are plenty. And we represent just a wide array of professional experiences.
And of course, a very successful call center here in Rhode Island is too, again, having a variety of skill sets needed. And let's talk a little bit about the groups that are at IGT. So Pride at IGT, Super Abilities. So, you know, folks who come to IGT, as you talked about the family sort of perspective of it, there really, it sounds like, you know, there's a community and lots of interacting communities. So talk a little bit about the groups.
Sure. Part of our diversity and inclusion strategy was to create what we call diversity and inclusion groups. And what they are really networks of employees that are organized by employees around some dimension of diversity. And that really is a way of us creating a community within our larger IGT family. And so we actually have five diversity and inclusion groups that are really organized around different dimensions of diversity. And so if I could give you a few, we have Super Abilities at IGT, which is a title I love. And it is representative of our employees and caretakers of people with disabilities. And I love that you changed the title, and it's about what's your super ability. And we also have Pride with IGT, which is dedicated to our employees and supporters for our LGBTQ employees and people. And we also have Greater Than 50 at IGT. For those of us who are 50 years plus, Greater Than 50 is really talking about the evolution of the work experience as we emerge into our 50s and above, and how professional development and other opportunities are still very important to our employees. The other area that we have, the other group, is Military Veterans at IGT, which focuses our attention both from a recruitment perspective and meeting the needs of our employees who have served, proudly served, and we want to be sure that they have an incredible experience at IGT. And we also have Win with IGT. Win with IGT is our women's inclusion network. We have multiple chapters, one here in Rhode Island. We have a chapter in Reno, Nevada, Las Vegas, and elsewhere. And that really brings together the opportunity to provide professional and leadership development for women within our organization, and to really help the business grow, bring in diverse perspectives.
And so, I think you hit all five. With so much going in IGT, a lot also goes on outside of IGT, both with the role within the community, and then in the industry-wide, IGT was one of the founding members of the All-In group. So let's talk about that. Again, we always love to get outside the box, get outside the myopic look. You know, what does that mean for, you know, to be an industry leader in this as well, and learning from other organizations?
Yeah, one of the things that we focus on, both from a talent perspective and really just networking with others in the business, is to make people aware of the incredible opportunities that exist in the gaming and lottery business. And All-In Index, they are a newly created index that focuses on diversity and inclusion metrics and benchmarking specific to the gaming industry. And so it is actually a groundbreaking initiative, and we were very proud to be part of that founding membership group to add our thought leadership to the issue of creating diversity within the industry. I think one of the other benefits, though, to being here in Rhode Island is that there's a growing community of companies here who are focused on diversity and inclusion. So in addition to All In, we partnered here in Rhode Island with diversity and inclusion professionals to create the very first, what we call Diversity Links, which is to really bring together professionals across multiple dimensions of diversity to network, to talk with each other, and to really be able to think about best practices. And sometimes that involves a social component and really getting to know each other so that we can actually bring the best back to our respective companies. So networking and really meeting others who are committed to diversity and inclusion is something that has been really a great experience for me to be here in Rhode Island and to develop this strong network of D&I professionals.
So now that we've lured you to Rhode Island and you're at IGT, What's your favorite part? You talk about the family of IGT, liking being here, but you know, the beaches, the restaurants, you know, what has maybe, you know, gotten your eyes, surprised you, has really said, wow, I really like this about Rhode Island?
You know, the size. I lived in Chicago for 25 years, which is where I relocated from, but I also grew up in New York City. And growing up in two big cities like that, there are lots of gems that you just never get to because there are so many people. And I love the size of Rhode Island. I love its accessibility. I love the fact that I can usually find parking when I want to go to a festival. We took our family to the beach and actually have family coming in this weekend and we'll be hitting some of the beaches. You know, even the airport. I love that I can actually get to the airport.
How easy is green, by the way?
Absolutely. It spoils me. But really, it really speaks to, I think, that once you're here in Rhode Island, you do get the opportunity to explore it, and there's plenty. I barely skimmed the top of it. And I'm really excited to do a little bit more.
Well, fantastic. I appreciate your taking the time to come in here. Tell us a little bit more about yourself, your role at IGT as the first Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion, to let folks a little bit know about, more about what's going on in the company. So Kim Barker-Lee, thank you so much for taking the time to come in. And thank you for watching. We're going to be popping up here shortly, going just over the border to Battleship Cove, and an interesting story that you'll want to check out. So when you see us pop up, give us a look here on Go Local Live. I'm Go Local News Editor Kate Nagel.